fail. Sam Carmichael. Bill Austin. And Harry Bright. Good luck.
Guess who left their tickets on the kitchen table?
We said we have to get on this plane.
It's our best friend's birthday tomorrow!
We made such a fuss, we were in that plane even without the tickets.
So where's it then? Your Sky. We are dying to meet him.
How's your mom? I bet Donna's been going nuts over this wedding.
Yeah, well, listen. I've got a secret. And you're the only ones I can tell. I invited my dad to my wedding.
Your dad?
You mean you found him at last?
Well, not exactly. Look, I found Mom's diary in her desk.
Sophie, you're not supposed to go around reading your mom's diary.
No, she's supposed to go around reading yours.
But look, 1979, the one she kept the year she fell pregnant with me. You know how she won't talk about my dad and she says she can't remember. But listen to this. July 17th. What a night. After the show, Sam rode me over to the little island. Hmm. We danced on the beach.
Aww.
We kissed on the beach. Hmm. And dot, dot, dot.
What? Dot, dot, dot. It's what they did in the olden days.
Sam's the one. I know he is. I've never felt this before. August 4th. What a night! I was still feeling depressed about Sam when after the show, Bill rented a motorboat, so I took him over to the little island. One thing led to another, and dot, dot, dot.
Bill!
August 15th. What a night! Harry turns up out of the blue, so I showed him the little island. I must need my head examined. He was so sweet, I couldn't help it. And
dot, 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 dot!
So the sperm donor has a name. Well, three names. Sam, Bill, or Harry.
And they're all arriving for the wedding?
Yes.
Oh my God, do they know?
No, what do you write to a total stranger? Come to my wedding, you might be my dad. They think Mom sent invitations. And after what's in here, I'm not surprised they all said yes.
Oh, Soph, are you sure about this?
Yes. I want the perfect wedding, and I want my dad to give me away.
Oh, well, let's hope it's a wide aisle.
You have to keep Mom out of this. She mustn't know what I'm doing.
Well, she's bound to see them sooner or later.
I'm not having Mom frightening them off before I get to know them. And with any luck, I'll know my dad straight away.
And what if you don't?
Then I've got 24 hours to find out!
Thank you. hating these stupid stilettos.
What did you expect? A limo by the shore?
Yes, Donna knows we don't do walking.
Ah, well, look what the tide's washed in.
Hey, for one night.
And one night only.
It's Donna and the Dynamos!
Room hug!
Oh, sorry, darling, I just need to sit down, but tell us, how's the mother of the bride?
Oh, all the better for seeing all of you.
Auntie Rosie?
Sophie Sheridan, you get more gorgeous every time I see you. Don't I get a big fat kiss like, oi, coming all the way to your home? I bet you don't remember us.
All this plastic surgery.
Auntie Tanya, Rachel, Josie.
Oh, look at my baby.
Her whole life ahead of her.
Mom, I'm getting married, not joining the Foreign Legion.
Well, in my days, we didn't get married at 20.
No, nowadays we didn't get married, full stop.
A white wedding? I don't know where she gets it from.
Well, you can't blame me, Donna. You know it wasn't my idea.
Girls, meet the leading man at tomorrow's do. Sky, these are my best friends.
Hi, I've heard so much about you.
All bad, I hope.
Not about that. Cariño, camina por la sombrita. Que en el sol se derriten los bombones.
Sorry, I don't speak Greek.
My name is Pepper, but they call me Pimienta.
Because you're hot.
No, 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 it's because you always get stuck right up your nose.
Girls, Pepper and Alexia here. I'm a general help. Only generally, they are no help at all. Don't you two have any work to do?
Yes, sir.
Donna, the taverna looks wonderful.
Oh, we've got Sky to thank for that.
Well, Sky, one thing I would think is the bloody boat that brought us here. Although the captain was quite handsome.
Sink it? Why won't you sink it?
Well, it's a bit of an eyesore.
Well, that eyesore is going to be my floating casino.
What?
Yeah, the boys are transforming it into a millionaire's paradise.
Just picture it. Sailing around the islands and gambling under the stars.
Gambling millionaires? I bet there's a few of your ex-husbands aboard.
Don't think so, darling. I didn't leave them their millions. Well, this is going to be my jackpot, girls. I need a break. I mean, a holiday. I've been running this place for 15 years and I've never had a day off. I work all night, I work all day to pay the bills I have to pay. And still there never seems to be a single penny left for me. I fool around and
I'm glad to get off that boat.
Oh, that was nothing. You should try a kayak at the Okinawa swamps.
Oh, I read your book. A bloke in a boat in Botswana.
Thanks, Harry. Harry saw one copy somewhere.
Well, travel books are my passion. A distraction from the horrors of London Underground.
Do you two want to hear something really interesting? Do you see this taverna?
Well, I'm rather impressed. I was expecting an old hat here. I was reading we were going to sleep with the goats.
Goats? Give me goats over camels. It was this time in the Kalahari when the sun was beating down.
Oh, all right. Sorry to spoil the travel log, Indiana. The point is that this is my taverna. I built this. Well, no, I designed it. I drew up the plans, what it must be 21 years ago. I can't believe she's actually gone and built the bloody thing.
Who?
Well, Donna, who else? This is something I just scribbled down on the back of an old menu. I had no idea she would.
Do you think the island would inspire some prose?
I hope so.
Were you born here?
Oh, no, no, I was born and raised in London, but my mother's Greek. And about the only time I was in Greece was to visit my great aunt, and that was 21 years ago.
Well, now you can write about some taverna. The tourists will flock.
Good afternoon.
Oh.
Can I help you?
I'm Bill Austin. You have a room for me.
And I'm Bright.
Bill Austin?
Bright. Harry Bright.
Harry?
Yes.
So you must be...
Sam Carmichael, yeah. You were expecting us.
Yes. Yes, of course. I'll get the keys.
Well, I hope I get the chance to get my tongue around the little Greek.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I haven't spoken it for 21 years.
Hold on. 21 years? Now, this is beginning to sound a bit like a setup. Bill, here's a story for you. Three men, strangers, receive an invitation to a wedding. They're invited to a place they haven't visited for 21 years, by a woman they haven't seen for 21 years. Why are they here?
Well, that's not bad, but Harry, what's your excuse? What's on your way from the Bank of England?
Oh, is this an interview? Well, for me, Donna's invitation brought back many happy memories. Bloody hell!
Is that a quote?
I know this guitar. HB. Headbanger. That's what they used to call me those days. And here it is, D.S. Donna Sheridan. I bought this guitar for her. You know, hang on. We used to play this one.
Thank you for the music, the songs I'm singing. Thanks for the joy they're bringing. Who can live without it? I ask in all honesty. What would I be without a song or a dance? What are we? So I say thank you for the music, for giving it to me.
You're Donna's daughter.
Yes.
I never thought she had a...
I thought she looked familiar. So we are Sophia.
It's just Sophie.
Well, Sophie's pretty. I had a great tone, Sophia.
I'm named after a Sophia.
And where is Donna? I want to see her. I want to thank her for the invitation.
Oh, no, you mustn't. You're a secret. I send invitations. She doesn't know.
Why?
Because Mom's always talking about her friends from the old days, and I thought you'd just be thrilled if I invited you all.
Are you trying to tell us that Donna didn't invite us?
No. So just pretend that you're here for a holiday, and she'll get a lovely surprise when she sees you all at my wedding. We'll let her in on the secret. Mother says I was a dancer before I grew born. She says I began to sing long before I could talk. But I often wonder, how did it all start? Who found out that nothing could capture
the surprise, but the last time I saw your mother, she told me she never wanted to see me again.
But that was years ago, and I want you here.
But why?
Because it's my wedding, and I want everyone to be friends.
I thought I'd just drop in and say hi.
Shame. We don't have any rooms. It's that time of the year.
Just as well. I booked ahead.
This is so inconvenient.
Why?
Because there's a local girl getting married tomorrow and I just don't have the staff to cope with you all. You'd be so much more comfortable on the mainland.
Oh, no, not at all. Bill here is used to roughing it for his art. And old head banger, he's the last word in spontaneous.
And what about you?
Me? I came back to the island and see what...
Well, I'd like to stop and chat and chew over old times, but I have to go and clean out my handbag or something.
It does not wither her.
I was expecting a rather stout matron.
No, she's still Donna.
That Donna, an icon of female independence, would have a daughter getting married at 20.
Yeah, well, white weddings are trendy.
But what's wrong with these kids? Do you remember those t-shirts we used to wear? Marriage is an institution for people
who belong in an institution.
Right. Girls today seem to think that their major achievement is getting a man.
You've had three husbands.
I raise my case.
No, ooh, look what I found!
Oh my God, we were so young. Don and the Dynamos, remember? Yes.
So much better than Tina and the Turbine.
Ugh. Tina. They were so obnoxious, always copying us. Hey, but we could rock these outfits.
I don't know what the girls at my book club would say about these outfits.
Why not think about doing a bachelor's party tonight?
Yes!
But look, I think I have to let out those scenes.
Because where's Sophie?
I haven't seen her. Why?
I must find her now.
Ta-da!
It was in the trunk!
My God, that's all I want.
We should hang it in the bar. Show Sophie what a cool mom she's
got. Burn it, I never want to see this again.
No, what's up?
I must be dreaming.
What's wrong?
Any moment, I'm going to wake up and they'll have all gone away.
Donna, what is it?
Nothing. Leave me alone. I can't talk about it. I knew this would happen. All my life has just been tapping me on my shoulder. Of course it was going to come out. It had to. God, why was I such a stupid little idiot?
Like this, there is no way you can deny. her dad.
Who's dad?
Sophie's. You know how I always said that it was Sam, the architect, who ran home to get married?
Typical bloody man.
Yeah, well, I'm not really sure that it was him. You see, there were a couple of others.
Donna Sheridan, you cheeky thief!
Why didn't you tell us?
I didn't think I'd ever have to. I didn't think that all three would be sitting in my bar the day before their daughter's wedding.
Where?
No. Wait a moment, Donna.
You see?
Are you sure about this?
Is he there? Yes, I'm sure. You think I forget my daughter's dads? Sam, Bill Austin, and Harry Headbanger? Dear gods, why have they all turned up now? It's like some horrible trick of fate.
It is very Greek.
But I won't let them spoil things. They have no right to turn up like this. I mean, what have they ever done for their daughter?
Donna, be fair. They didn't even know she existed.
And they don't need to know. I've done a bloody good job raising Sophie all by myself. And now I don't need three possible fathers from the past banging at my door. Look, tonight there is no men at the ladies' night. And tomorrow we will take them fishing.
Fishing? Oh, please.
But what do you suggest we do with three men?
Well, that does take me back.
You dumb bat. You should have told us.
I remember Bill Austin. He was quite all right.
Yes.
Oh, it's just a laugh, a minute to you. But I'm the one who fell pregnant.
Oh, this just about serves me right.
Oh, now you sound just like your mother.
I do not.
Yes, you do.
Whatever happened to Donna, the life and soul of the party, and Rat Cheek Supremo?
She grew up, that's all.
Come on, Donna. Get back down there. You've done anything wrong.
Thank you.
going?
Ah, hello. Well, we've got lap dances at Medusa's, then we've got mud wrestling at Orpheus. I even heard Pepper's bringing his handcuffs.
Don't go.
You what? And miss out on my last night of freedom?
I don't mean don't go. I mean, is that how you really see it?
Well, I see it as the last night before the greatest adventure of my life.
You know how I said I wanted a dad?
Sophie, we've been over this 1,000 times. You don't need a dad. I'm here, okay?
Yeah, well, Skye, whatever happens, you'll never leave me, will you?
You crazy? You've turned my world upside down. I wasn't jealous before we met. Now every man that I see is a potential threat. And I'm possessed.
Thank you.
What are you doing here?
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Girls' night, women only.
Ooh. Get out. Oh, no, girls, wait. It's okay. Let's see if they have the guts to stay.
Not so fast, Donna. And the daffodils.
Tina!
What are you doing
here?
Sky!
No, wait. I was kidnapped by Betty White and the Golden Girls, I swear!
Oh, come on, he's all right.
For your information, it's Donna and the Dynamos.
Dynamos? Are you sure it's not dynamite? You seem to have used it all, and you fake.
She's so mean.
Listen to her. Yeah, no. You're right. I bet they still can sing.
Oh, really? Try me.
Money went to family. How old are you?
I'm 20. Wait! She won't talk about the past. She doesn't understand. But I need to know. My whole life has been one big unanswered question, and I don't want any more secrecy. Bill, are you my father?
I think so.
You know what comes next?
Don't tell me you have a twin sister.
Will you give me away?
Give you away?
I feel like a proper bride if I can walk down the aisle with my father.
Let's take this party outside!
I'll find your mother!
No, no, wait! Let's wait till after the wedding. It's a secret.
All right, I'll do it!
We'll be right back.
going on? Sophie, it's 6 o'clock in the morning. What are you doing at the beach?
Oh, I don't know.
Wait, right there.
I'm all right, Mom.
Of course you're not all right. You're sleepwalking again.
Again? When do I ever sleepwalk?
Well, let's see. The night you couldn't do your timetables. The night you went down with measles.
Knock it off. I'm not a baby.
Well, I know that, Sophie. But you're still my daughter, and I know when there's something wrong. Where do we start? I can sort out this wedding nonsense.
Nonsense? What do you mean, nonsense?
Sorry, it's just a figure of speech.
No, it isn't. That's what you think, isn't it? That I'm too young to get married, and it's just a label, and it's just stupid.
I'm not pretending that I understand, Sophie.
Of course you don't. You did just fine without a man, didn't you? You didn't do all the marriage and the baby thing. You just did the baby thing. Well, good for you.
Why are you having a go at me?
I'm gonna do it right, Mom. I love Skye, and I wanna be with him. And I'm not gonna have my kids growing up not knowing who their father is, because that's just crap!
Sophie?
Ooh-la, ooh, I'm taking only, now it's only...
All right, all right, girls. You should be helping Sophie get ready.
We went to the beach to collect this.
You were up all night?
We think they would look great as necklaces. We wanted to see the sunrise. It's good luck for the wedding.
What are you talking about?
You see, there is an ancient island tradition that says that the bride's friends have to sleep.
Come on, what sort of a wedding is this gonna be? Girls, go and help Sophie and Skye. You're not marrying my daughter smelling like a sewer. Now hit the shower.
Sir.
Yes, sir.
Donna, what's the rush?
A small matter of the wedding, Sam.
Look about this wedding. This is my old bungalow.
Oh, they frighten off unwanted visitors.
You know, you don't need a bungalow to do that.
I wouldn't. My bite is worse than my bark.
I know. I've still got the scars. I can show you.
Well, what do you want, Sam?
Look, I've had an idea for an extension.
I don't need your bloody extension. What are you doing here?
You're living my dream. Don't you remember? The island. The taverna. It was my dream.
Yeah? Well, this is my reality. Hard work and a crippling mortgage.
Oh, all right. Let me at least take a look at the roof for you. It's not going to last you through the winter.
I can take care of my own roof. Thank you.
Oh, all right. Be a bloody martyr. I've got kids. I know it's hard for you doing it on your own.
Don't you dare patronize me. I like doing it on my own. Every morning I wake up and I thank Christ I haven't got some middle-aged menopausal man to bother me. I'm free, I'm single, and it's great.
Where are those happy days? They seem so hard to find. I try to reach for you, but you have closed your mind. Whatever happened to our love? I wish I understood. It used to be so nice, it used to be so good. Love you gave me nothing else can save me, SOS.
tell me about Sophie?
That is none of your business.
And what's this guy bloke like? Is he good enough for her?
That is none of your business either.
So when you're near me, darling, can't you hear me? S.O.S. The love you gave me, nothing else can save me. S.O.S. when you're gone, how can I even try to go on? When you're gone, though I try, how can I carry on?
Madam, this is the best drink from Cuba. It's called a mojito. It'll tickle your taste buds. You'll feel fire in your mouth. Fuego de noche, nieve de día.
Okay, but will it cure my hangover?
Just look at yourself in the mirror, because you just cured mine.
Hi, Harry.
Hi. What time is it? Shouldn't you be getting ready for the wedding?
Don't worry about me, darling. I've got plenty of time.
But Donna must be pulling her hair out, doing the wedding on her own. What would the bride's father usually do?
Usually he'd pay, though my dad threw the line at the third.
Well, too much sun for me. I'll go back to my room now.
No, wait, Harry, wait, don't go.
We'll catch up tonight.
Hey, Tanya, why don't we catch up from last night?
Look, darling, last night never happened. I don't want to remember last night. Is that all you caught, Bill?
Well, you should have seen the one that got away.
It was this big.
Oh, don't exaggerate.
Sorry, girls, I need to see Donna before the wedding.
She's in her room. We have 3 hours to melt down.
3 hours? Well, okay, girls, let's go. We've got a lot of work to do.
Yeah.
Work?
Yes, honey, on my face, a little repair and renovation.
You don't mess with perfection.
Oh, you bastard. Just ignore him, Tanya. Too much Latin music fried his brain.
Look, men who play with fire get their fingers burnt.
Driving you wild.
take it easy. Better slow down, girl.
Ain't no place to go. Just your mother knows.
Take it easy.
Take it easy.
Better cool it, girl. Take it nice and slow.
The wedding is in hours. Get out of here, go. Donna's going crazy. Are you?
Skye!
Dad, it's bad luck to see each other before the wedding.
It's all gone wrong anyway. You have to help me.
Why? What's happened?
It's all a mess and it's all my fault. I know I shouldn't have, but I read Mom's diary and I've got three possible dads.
Hell.
I invited them all to the wedding, and I thought I'd know who my father was as soon as I saw him, but I didn't.
Okay, slow down, back up. You did what?
I invited my dad to our wedding. It was 3 months ago. I wasn't even sure they all come. You've got to help me.
Why didn't you tell me?
Because I knew you wouldn't like it.
Is that what this big white wedding is for? Just a setup so you could meet your dad?
No, it's not.
But I wanted to take a boat out to the mainland. Just get married in front of a few drunk witnesses. But you insisted on having this fantasy wedding just so that you could play happy families?
It's knowing who I am. I wanted to get
married.
It
doesn't come from knowing who your dad is, Soph. It comes from you. How would you feel if I'd lied to you? I was marrying you because I love you. I thought that's what you wanted. I guess I don't know anymore.
You don't know if you love me?
Don't know if that's what you want.
I'm sorry I'm interrupting.
No, it's just think about
no,
it.
No, wait, Skye, please, I need your help.
Wait, Sophie, he's right. You've got to be sure it's what you really want.
This has nothing to do with you.
But I'm your dad. I can't give you away unless I know you're gonna be really happy.
I've had this conversation with my mother, and she knows me a lot better than you do.
Yeah. What does Donna the Dynamo know about marriage or divorce? Look, Sophie, I've got 20 years of good advice to cram into about 2 minutes, so just hear me out. You're so young. You've got your whole life ahead of you.
Not now, Sam, please.
But I've been there. I've done the big white wedding, and I've done the cake. And you know, it doesn't always turn out happy ever after.
You said you had boys.
Yeah. They live with their mom.
Well, that's you, not me. I love Skye more than anything else in this world. Did you feel that when you got married?
No, I didn't.
Well then, it will be all right. I know it will.
There was something in the air.
Hair right, can't get anything right.
Excuse me, Donna?
Harry! Harry, what are you doing here?
I wanted to give you this.
No, I don't mean here. I mean here on this island.
Please.
Jesus, Mary and Joseph, what's this?
Well, you've been looking after Sophie all those years on your own, so I wanted to contribute a little something for the wedding.
Well, this would cover 4 weddings and a funeral. Harry, it's a lovely gesture, but...
That phrase again.
What?
You know what was the last time you said that to me?
No.
It was the night I bought you the guitar. I remember thinking, those are the last words I'll ever hear from Donna, and I always treasure them. Oh, Harry, it's a lovely gesture, but...
sure you're making that up. I'm sure I just said thank you nicely, like a well-brought-up Catholic girl.
That's better. It's the first time I've seen you smile since I've arrived.
Well, I'm a little bit stressed, Harry. What do you expect?
Well, you know, a little more of the old Donna, a little less of the Catholic girl.
Harry, I can't take this. I don't know why you think I should.
I want you to have it.
Mom? Yes, come in.
I'll see you tonight at the wedding.
The wedding?
Yes. I've been invited.
Oh, is that the dress then? Mm-hmm. It's marvelous how the girl's ready to help you.
Mom, will you help me?
Really much of a choice, did I? An unmarried mom in the 70s? My mother disowned me. But I couldn't have had it any other way. Imagine living with your grandmother in a rainy estate in England.
Sometimes I wish that I could freeze a picture and save it from the funny tricks of time.
Proud of you.
Sam.
Sophie tells me you're giving her away.
Yes, I am. Who else?
What about her dad?
Her dad? No, her dad isn't here.
It's what she wants. She told me she wants her father here. Maybe her father wants her as well.
What? Don't do this to me now, Sam. I don't want to hear this now.
Donna, listen. This is about us.
I don't want to talk about the things we've gone through, though it's hurting me. Now it's history. I've played all my cards, and that's what you've done too. Nothing more to say. No more race to play. The winner takes. That's her destiny. I was in your arms.
might be strong there, but I was a fool, playing by the rules. The gods may throw the dice, their minds as cold as ice. The loser has to fall. It's simple and it's plain. Why should I complain? I don't want to talk, 'cause it makes me feel sad. But I understand. You've come to shake my hand. I apologize if it makes you feel bad seeing me so tense. No self-confidence, but you see, the winner takes it all.
With the other tea, I finish, please.
I just got this note from Sophie. She wanted me to give her away, but now she has changed her mind. I'm confused. I don't know where I am. I don't know who I am. I just came here for a wedding.
Huh?
Look, and Sophie's that. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
You need to have a conversation with Donna.
You're right. I go now.
No, not now. Sophie is getting married in 5 minutes. And so, go take a pew and botany it, I don't know.
Will it be all right for me to be here?
Oh, for God's sake.
Well, to tell the truth, I was praying that I wouldn't walk down the aisle anyway. Marriage, church, responsibility. I'm a writer. I decided long ago, I walk alone path.
Well. Change your mind, I'm the first in line. Honey, I'm still free, take a chance on me. If you need me, let me know, gonna be around. If you've got no place to go, if you're feeling down, if you're all alone.
We can go walking, welcome. Welcome to Sophie and Sky and to all your friends who are gathered here today. Welcome especially to Donna, who represents your family. Dearly beloved, we're gathered here today as a community to celebrate.
And welcome to Sophie's dad.
What?
I'm sorry to interrupt you, but this is important. I have to tell you he's here.
I know.
What?
I invited him.
You couldn't. I don't know which one of them it is.
Oh my God.
Oh dear.
I'm really, really sorry, Mom. Will you ever forgive me?
I don't know, Sophie. Will you forgive me?
Of course, you're my mom.
Hang on. Are we saying that I might be Sophie's dad? But it might be Bill, or it might be even Harry?
Yeah, you got it.
You don't waste your time.
Well, don't get so self-righteous with me. You've only got yourself to blame.
You what?
Yeah, if you hadn't dumped my mom and gone off and married someone else.
Ooh.
No. It wasn't like that. I was engaged. I had to go home. I thought it was the right thing to do. But I came back.
What?
Yeah. I told Lorraine I couldn't marry her, and I came straight back.
Why didn't you call me?
Because when I got here, they told me you had gone off with some other bloke. So I went back to Lorraine, who told me what an idiot I was, and married me to prove it.
Excuse me, if I may interrupt for a
moment. Oh, Harry, the check, I'm sorry.
Forget a check, it's yours. What I want to say is, it's great to have even a third of Sophie.
Well, he's right. We can find out if we want to, but I agree with Harry. Being a third of your dad is great money.
Me too.
Bloody typical. Wait 20 years for one dad, and suddenly three come along?
I don't know which one of you my dad is, but I don't mind. I've learned something about myself. Sky, let's not get married. I know you didn't want any of this anyway. Let's just get off this island and get out the world.
I love you.
Donna, I take it the wedding's canceled?
Captain, I haven't got the clue what's going on.
Should we then maybe turn this into a fundraising event?
Hold on. Why waste a good wedding? How about it, Sheridan? You're gonna need Body to boss around on this island of yours.
Are you nuts? I am not a bigamist.
Neither am I. I'm a divorced man who's loved you for 21 years. And ever since I got on this island, I've been bursting to show you how much.
Aww.
Donna, will you marry me? Come on, Donna. It's only the rest of your life.
I can't conceal it. Don't you see? Can't you feel it?
Say I do.
Donna, let's try it. You love me.
Thank you.